Hollywood.
Upside down TV.
It's really weird.
The bedroom of his Encino home.
Singer Michael Jackson was admitted with severe burns to his scalp, as far as we know.
Michael Jackson. The Guinness Book of World Records has listed Thriller as the biggest-selling album of all time.
Michael Jackson has become the first artist in the history of music to generate 6 number one singles off one album. The album, of course, is Bad.
What Michael Jackson has achieved is a tribute to 20 years of hard work, energy, tireless dedication. Your success is an American dream come true.
Midget's here, of course.
Here, you guys can watch. Don't change your channel.
Music.
Soon you'll see me.
And soon you'll see me.
And then you'll see him and back to me. Today's
actually,
show.
Actually watching this is kind of creepy.
So we're gonna talk about Michael today. Weather. Michael Jackson. I like him. Do you want to hear my personal opinion?
No, not yet. Hold on. Let's watch some of this.
I like him.
This is very impressive. This time of his career, right?
Why? Because my opinions are right.
I think they are.
I use logic. And my sensitivity.
Yeah, bring this up. Welcome everybody to the show. These guys look great, don't they? Look at them all. Give yourself a hand. We got a live studio audience. Some special guests over there. And of course we're showing some Michael Jackson footage because of the recent skirmish that Michael's under. You got some headlines, don't you?
Yeah, I love Michael. Love Michael.
You love him now?
I love him now and even more than so. And I have to tell you my personal opinion on that later.
All right, well, just read what happened in court yesterday.
What happened in court?
Lower the volume on the footage a little bit.
Well, with a nod of his head, Michael Jackson pleaded not guilty Friday to a grand jury indictment that expanded the child molestation case against him to include a conspiracy count involving allegations of child abduction, false imprisonment, and extortion. How did you put it, camera guy?
How do you attemptedly molest a kid?
No. I just want to know.
I want to know how you get in this much trouble. 12 counts.
How do you accidentally molest someone? That's what I want to know.
I think he's been doing it for a long time, ever since Tito and his father was playing with him as a young boy. I mean, that all happened. I know that happened.
You have to hear my personal opinion on this.
Well, go ahead.
Well, I just want to know how you accidentally molest someone. It's like you accidentally raped someone. Whoops, I didn't. Whoops, it fell in.
Oh, his pants fell down while we were
whoops,
playing on the swings.
Whoops, my pants fell down. And, you know, how do you accidentally molest somebody? I don't get that.
So, what do you think? I know you. It's hard for you to give an opinion because,
you
know, you're both in the same music business, but...
Just leave him alone, son. Word is bond.
Well, let's say, for instance...
I went and supported Kurt that night. One of the cameras when he came from court.
Yeah.
And I went up to the Netherlands and I supported him.
I think it's great that you supported him, but let me ask you a question. Let's do a scenario. Let's say, for instance, the 12 counts, they're just reaching for stuff, trying to cover all their bases, the prosecution, but let's say if he did it. One time. Just one time. I mean, what do you think about that?
He didn't do it.
He never did it.
I don't think he's too smart. He's got, you know,
so who's framing him? Why are they doing it to him?
He makes too much money because they told him to step down and didn't step down. They told him, look, take a back seat. We need somebody else to be the new papa or whatever.
Well, when you look at some of this footage, it's...
King of pop and all that.
When you look at some of this footage, it's hard to find someone else that's surpass what he's done. I'll tell you that.
That's what I'm
go
saying.
Full screen on this and watch some of this.
I give you mad props. Yo, Mike, keep your head up, son. You know what I'm saying? You know who this is.
Yeah. Yeah, he's definitely, this is the greatest time for him. But, you know.
Well, I don't know. I think, look, you make a whole bunch of money in your whole life. I think, honestly, and he's done so much good charity work. I don't care what anybody says. I think he's a great person. I think he's entitled to do pretty much damn well anything he wants to do.
Including molest children, allegedly?
Not only is he allowed to do anything he wants, I think people will almost let him do anything they want to him. And my other opinion is, look, I think there's a lot of really sick people out there doing whatever they're doing. And I think there's a lot of people getting molested out there and getting hurt and molested by a lot of people the improperly way. And hey, if Michael Jackson did it, at least he did it with some dignity, and at least he was nice about it. No, I'm serious. I would rather Michael Jackson molest my kids than anybody else, personally.
I would say
I was molested by some people when I was young, you know, and I didn't like, and if Michael Jackson was molesting me, I think I would have turned out to be a lot nicer of a person
especially if he molested you at Neverland, right?
Yes, I mean,
it's a nice place. There's rides and things to do while you're getting molested in between.
It's not my business. It's not anyone's business. Honestly, I don't think it's like none of our business. Why do we have to poke into someone else's life? And so what if he did it? That's my business.
Why?
That's not my business.
Why would you be stupid enough to know all the media is watching him and he's under scrutiny? And to go and sit up and do the same thing over that he's been accused of already.
And I think
perhaps if it's true,
you can't be that stupid, man. Nobody is.
If you're that wealthy, I think everybody's jealous of you and they just try to find anything to knock you down. And that's the one thing they can knock him down with. So that's what like people choose to knock him down with, as much as they can, just because he's
so
wealthy.
They made an allegation, now they can ride
it. Yeah, they got to prove their case.
They make it true whether it's not. Once it hits the papers, people is going to say, whatever, man. That's what's up, yo. I'm just saying, man. Y'all niggas come at me, son. Word is born, man. You won't just have them nuts in your mouth. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
You'll be feeling a 45 down your throat. Word up.
Well, we're going to see what happens, Silk, in the upcoming weeks with the trial and everything. But I got a surprise for you. I got a surprise for Silk. Do you mind? We're always doing video productions and stuff, and Silk is one of our productions.
I know.
We're working on his new music video called Dawn of All Dawns, right?
One second. I was just saying, and I'm not speaking to just anybody out there. I'm speaking to just certain people who go after people, not just media, because the media can make you or break you, and the media's not bad to me. They don't bother me. But just certain people making allegations, we all gotta stop.
You know what? I had a paranoid delusion that perhaps if I was Michael, I would think, well, maybe my record label is trying to frame me to bring me down. To put the kibosh on his success, because he's not selling any records now, and they want to end the contract.
That's it.
Everybody's
jealous. It's the big boys bringing down the talent, man.
Another story like, what's his name? That cat with the long fingernails.
Kobe?
No.
9 Inch Nails?
What about Kobe?
Howard Hughes. Yep. Howard Hughes.
Oh, Howard Hughes. Right.
Howard Hughes, yeah, long fingernails. All right, listen. So listen, I don't want you to
shit in between.
I don't want you to shoot me. I don't want you to get mad at me either. Silk.
Yeah.
But, you know, we worked on, lower the volume on the movie and bring up that other video.
Okay.
This is a shoot we did last Thursday. Silk had it all arranged. We were helping. We had it all together. We got this big house. We had 100 extras. We're ready to shoot a big video. And these are some of the dancers that you, Silk, you never saw any of this because you hadn't gotten there yet.
No.
So roll that video, and you'll see some of the dancers. Bring us up full screen. Take us off.
I was told to go home.
You
got to
understand something. When the Don says he's going to be there at 4 o'clock, that's what time it is.
Yeah, but I told you a 9 o'clock call, so in my eyes, you're 6 hours
late. I got there at 3 o'clock, so I was really early, son.
Oh, okay. Now, here's some of your dancers. Check it out.
That's awesome.
I seen her later.
She came back, too.
She came. Get a scene with us.
You got to thank our floor manager today, Sage, because she brought all those people back.
Yeah, no doubt. Sage is keeping working. She's doing her thing. And Brian, you know, they...
So check out your dancers, so. These are all your dancers that were at the... You know, hold on. He's got those loose knees. What do you think so far, so? Now this one's questionable. What kind of dancing is that anyway? It's the beginning of a striptease.
Tell them they gotta wear thongs the next time, everybody.
We'll have them all naked too.
No more.
Look at this one. I think. Hey, I like that. You guys in the booth are awesome.
Hey, you got some nice cream up in there. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah, right. That one girl, she was like doing something. Looked like she was sewing.
She looks like Nanny the Professor.
Since you didn't, you were coming late, so I had to tell Bridget to turn around and go home. So I didn't know if you were gonna come or not. I'm sorry for jumping the gun, but here's Mighty Mike. We had another midget there for him.
All right, I can dig. He's doing his thing.
Look at his moves.
That nigga gets down. You tell him he's always welcome.
He is. He wanted money. I told him that we didn't have any, but...
That's questionable.
Yeah. Now look at this one. This is a nice one. What do you think, Soap? Doug, yeah, I can dig that. Do a good job casting?
Yeah, I can dig that.
All right, look at this one.
Oh, that's Dr. Petrie.
Now, who the hell is that?
Dr. Petrie, across between Truman Capote and Bigfoot.
I can dig it.
All right. All right. She was good, too. She was awesome. Now, there's some funny-looking girl in a jersey right there. I don't know what she's doing. Yeah. And this was the house. They never cleaned the dishes.
Yeah, these fucking guys.
Look at the beautiful pond in the backyard. That's what we had to shoot around.
You want to know something?
I made you sign.
I told you motherfuckers to have that shit clean.
Look what happened before you got there. Look.
What's up, man?
Look at that. Silk, that was for you, baby.
Oh, I can see some nipples.
Hold on. Brian, what happened?
We were at this house shooting. Well, we didn't even shoot. We were just lighting. And the owner showed up, and he said, "You got to get out."
So what the hell? I don't know. Well, they wrapped us.
Why all these fucking people show up, man? This shit happened.
With other white women there.
All right, we got to... John, no, what do you think happened?
Hold on.
I think it's just a big misunderstanding right now.
Where's Silk?
Silk thought it was 4 o'clock, and I told him it was 9 o'clock. Big misunderstanding.
All he wants some money, man. He knows, but this wasn't, we all just got here too early.
What's your name again?
Are we going to be able to shoot the video?
I don't know. I don't think so. Shit, what's the name?
Have you talked to Silk?
Nope, I ain't called Silk yet. Holler at something, man. Ain't nobody getting in contact with Silk right now.
What were you doing, bro?
I forgot about the video shoot.
I was getting my pictures, man.
See, now everybody's Silk. It's about 3 o'clock. Everybody's ready to leave because you haven't shown up yet.
Trying to take care of three wives.
This is the owner of the house moving out all our prop furniture because he didn't want us to shoot there.
Yeah, we're striking his head.
We're striking his head.
Call the beer. There's not one thing left here. Except a roll of toilet paper.
I got the toilet paper hole.
I had that filled with beer for you, Silk. I spent $120 at the market fixing it.
I appreciate you getting back. You know what happened, Shane?
Now what? Listen to this. This is where the riot starts. All right, this is the owner of the house throwing out the tenant who said we could shoot in the house, but he was evicted a week before. So we had no permission.
The night before.
Yeah, the night before we talked to him, he got evicted. We got any phone calls? I don't think so. No. Nobody wants to call him. So look, here, they're trying to fix it now.
Man, if the midget was there, maybe I could have made everybody happy.
Well, you know.
I could have been running around naked. Come on, let us stay.
They would have stayed for that.
So Wally, you're the director of the Silkski video. What happened, man?
Well, apparently, I thought it was everything permitted, but you know, I guess some guy's supposed to be paying rent on the 1st, but it's like now the 22nd, and they still haven't paid the rent from April. So they're just basically standing here for free, and we thought we was gonna get
this is like the greatest drama.
Free, but
this is real. This is real.
This is reality TV trying to do a music video without a permit.
I don't know if you got more tape.
I think it's hilarious.
Let me tell you something, man. That's because a motherfucker who set me up with this place didn't have a straight down.
You're the director of the video.
He's going to be here in about 5 minutes.
Can you hold on a second, caller?
I will get you. I think we're going to shoot.
How are we going to shoot? We're striking the set.
Yeah, see, everybody wanted to leave, Silk. We were trying. Brian and I were trying to hold him back. All the actors were leaving.
This isn't how all rap productions are they?
Not exactly like this, but it's
listen.
Like this.
Even when they spend money,
not the
it's a disaster, right?
It's a disaster all the time.
Hey.
What we got going on out here?
You don't like rap music?
So what do you think about the video? What do you think about what just happened?
What part? The part that we got
thrown out of the house we were shooting.
I think it's bullshit.
It's a great dancer.
This should have been okay before we got up in here. I think it is bullshit. We should be up in here flowing. We should be up in here partying. You know what I'm saying?
And in defense of you and I, because we put this house together, we had no idea that this guy wasn't a legal tenant and was giving us the house and didn't have any control over it at all.
Yeah, so
we
don't like this.
Yeah, we should. But listen to the rest of these people.
I worked on Kanye West video like 2 weeks ago, and it was cool. And it was at the Ambassador Hotel, so I don't think it's a rap thing. It's just sometimes you'll think something is all set in stone, and then the person that you're working with is shady.
Just so wearing them out. Thought we're gonna make a whole bunch of money off their house.
Watch, this is funny. Check this out.
I thought I was DPing. It looks like I'm getting the hell out of here. More like
the police are coming.
Get the fuck out.
Wait, hold on.
The police are coming. We got to get out of here.
Yeah, I know, and I can't be here because I got warrants.
You got warrants too?
Yeah, that's maggot.
That's funny, isn't it?
I plead the fifth.
What did you do on the video today?
I was an AD, first AD, assistant director, and this is my boy. Prime right here.
That all rap music video productions go something like that. Is that true?
Some shit always happens. I guarantee you that.
What do you attribute that to?
I attribute that to shit. Being fucked up.
You know, it's going all the way from fucking LA to do this goddamn video, and the cops are gonna break it the fuck up. This is shit. Not to mention, we didn't even get paid for this shit. So now I have to spend my own gas to come fucking out.
So they're moving all the
trucks. Watch this.
We gotta put this back downstairs.
Why don't we just put it in the back of the truck?
See, Silk, I tried to steal that chair, but they wouldn't let us take it.
Hey, Sheila. I want to ask you a question. What do you think about the fact that Silk hasn't arrived yet? It's almost 3 o'clock.
I think that ain't good, man. I think if Silk was here, something could have been worked out, you know?
Bobby knows. When I got there, 5 minutes later, everything changed.
Most rap videos,
I told him motherfuckers, I gave him an offer they can't refuse.
I want to know personally, did you give him money?
Professional ones, like he said, if you got the shit right.
What was the offer?
You pay the people, whoever location you use to get the permits or whatever. But if you have, do it.
I know.
So your advice is to pay, not try to get it.
We're not exactly national, but we are kind of international.
But I own my house.
Wait, watch this.
Someone called the cops on me because we didn't have a permit. So
can we shoot at your house?
shit, I got kids that
have Negro time attitudes with a budget of zero. Which is really fucked up.
What do you think of these Negroes that
like
set
Silk
up a situation?
They like Silk. Talking about, where John at? Nigga, fuck where John is. Nigga, you got a number. Call that motherfucker. Why? Because you want him to over there supervise some shit that you have unsupervised? You want to...
It happened. What is what we planned? And we didn't want to happen, but it was bound to happen.
Did you give any shots to the cops? Did they ever come?
Do all
you
rap videos end like this?
Well, hold
nah,
on. I'll tell
if
you.
They're so put together, right?
I think he faked it. Try to pimp Silk out of some money.
I don't know.
We gonna be a dancer?
Mm-hmm. That's all it was.
So what do you think about what just happened? You got thrown out of the house we were working in.
I know. I'm kind of upset just because I came over from Orange County. So right now I'm stuck out here with no gas and I don't know.
You need a couple of dollars?
Right. Well, look here. I love this. Watch what happens here. She was stuck out there. She had no way to get home.
Here, Michael. Give her the $5.
Give you some head.
She needs my gas money. Hold on one sec.
Look, we know you a real baller. And we know you got an answer to a man at home. You probably got the kids on the side.
Hey.
Look, here.
Don't bring my home life into this.
Yes, it
will.
Don't get your
Mercedes, it's all theatrics. That's all it is. So you notice we gave her gas money to go home.
Been breaking shit down.
You gotta go back to Santa Barbara.
What
were you gonna do in the video?
It was a casting call at 10 o'clock.
And so what do you think about what just happened?
I think it was supposed to be people. The problem was not getting permits and shit. You gotta make everything legal.
Okay. I agree.
I'm very selective.
People's anger will go up.
Do you have anybody to blame?
Silkski.
And you got the shot you wanted.
Excuse me. Yeah, we got the permit. You're gonna be on TV.
Well, hold on, Silk, watch.
Factor, come on.
Some old man in a car drove by and honked at us.
That was the one called.
Yeah, he called the cops. Hold on.
Hey, where are you going? Don't you want to be in the video?
Fuck yeah. Hey, so what's happening?
Well, we got thrown out of the house we were shooting in because the person that rented us
that's
the house.
Midgets are ugly, except me.
Don't you think he's
yesterday.
Good looking?
Yeah.
Huh? Shit. So the real owner came and now we have to go.
He has a big
and Silk hasn't even shown up yet. What do you think about that?
And, like, that's shitty. Funny that's nose why I'm here. Right here. It's all
I'm
like...
glad you came back. It shows you're a diehard.
All right, man. That's it.
All right, that's it.
I think he's got a big
that's
head.
Silk, well, I'm glad we did the video.
It goes longer. But...
It goes longer, but, we, you
well,
know,
yeah,
we had
to talk
bring,
about
bring
this.
Bring the movie back up.
I want the audience's personal opinion on...
All right, we need to take some calls because I need to...
Can I get a close-up of this, please?
All right.
Hopefully. Oh, shit. Are you still there?
Hi.
All right, hold on, caller. We need your opinion. Bridget's new CD is coming out in a couple of weeks. I've just finished designing the album cover. Get a close-up of this, and we want your opinion of what you think of this album cover.
Of this font. I like the album.
Just give it in general. Don't just...
I like the holes in the fishnet stockings. Very sexy.
I like everything about it except the font, Bridget the Midget. I think it looks like what? Would you say, honey?
Early 80s roller disco.
Michael DeVine, if you keep slamming the doors, Michael, I'm going to have to...
Yeah, very nice. I like it. Very good.
Wait, I don't like the writing. What do you guys think?
If you were in a music store... Mm. If you were in a music store and you saw this sitting up on the shelves, would you want to buy it?
But they'd say change the writing and then buy it.
Well,
I don't like that
music.
Turn off that music. Or turn it down.
If you like,
I'm talking to a phone caller. What are you talking about?
If you like midgets, you'll like.
DeVine, get out of here.
No, you got to show me because I can't.
I have a question for.
All right, she's got a question. Bring down the music and
like
DeVine,
midgets,
get off the stage.
You'll like the music.
Here's another pack of Cracker Jacks.
Can I say this?
Get away.
How are you?
Here's a pack of Cracker Jacks.
We have a caller.
We're invading our show too.
We have a caller.
Well, Brian came in on my show.
Go, go. Bad dog.
You always come on ours.
Hi, Sage. Hadn't seen you since yesterday.
Right off.
All right. Caller, go ahead.
I have a question for the guy with the glasses. I just wanted to...
Which guy with the glasses?
...night last night.
Me.
Wait, hold on a second. Which guy with the glasses?
You.
Okay. Brian, what are you guys doing?
That guy with the glasses.
This one?
Yeah, you.
Yeah, what's your question?
If you had a hard night last night.
How do you know?
I can tell.
I did have a hard night.
I feel for you.
It wouldn't get hard at all. And thanks for calling and being so personal about it all, okay?
Okay.
Hello.
Oh, excuse me.
Hello.
God, I love Michael. His music is just,
I feel it in my soul.
Like I can feel that music in my bones. It's like heroin.
Yeah, caller. What do you think about the Michael Jackson problem? I think this is Michael. Who you got in there with you, bro? All right, he's talking too soft. Hello. Hello. All right.
Nothing there?
Yeah, well, when the callers learn how to speak up, we'll be able to do it. Oh, wait, I got a picture I want to show.
He's talking about wanting to get paid and...
Yeah, nobody gets paid around here. This is a picture we caught out in front of our office building. Bridget...
Oh, you guys.
Can you get closer, you guys?
What a horrible thing to take
Bridget,
a picture of.
Huh? Bridget is in the car and she's dragging her dog.
That's a horrible picture. My dog weighs like 1 pound, right?
Why were you doing that to the dog?
She wouldn't get in the car.
Hold it up.
I was gonna drive away if she didn't jump in the dog.
The poor little doggy. Poor little doggy. Anyway, so listen, I want to bring somebody on real quick. This is a new book by Lushan, right? Lushan, get a close-up. Kurt, get a close-up of this album cover. And get the microphone to Lushan, because she's a very interesting individual. Who's got it? Here it is. She just finished this book. Lushan, it's called Coming Out on the Dark. Can I see it?
Coming Out of the Dark,
okay. I just took a speed reading class, and I just, you know, just... Well, flip it upside down and turn the on switch to on. There you go. Okay, anyway, Lushan, tell us about yourself. Quickly, and tell us about your book.
Okay, well, as you said, the book is called Coming Out of the Dark. And I actually started writing the book when I was about 17 years old. I'm 30-something now. So,
wow.
It basically depicts a young black woman coming up in a middle-class area that was abused mentally and physically by my maternal aunt, my mother's sister, who was here with me. And
the abuser is with you now?
I want to know
who the abuser is.
No, she's deceased now.
Oh,
she
died.
She's deceased.
Now, let me get specific. What kind of emotional abuse did you have to endure growing up in her house?
Just to say a bun, I got my ass beat if the sun rose and when it set, basically. If she had a good day or a bad day, it was just because I was there, basically. And that's never a good reason for anyone to endure any type of be it physical or mental.
How did that affect you now?
I think it made me a stronger woman, is what it did. I didn't let it fuck my head up. You know, I took it, I turned it around, I turned the tables around. But it took a while, it didn't happen overnight. I was on the streets at 15 years old. I slept on the corner of Santa Monica and Western on a bus bench for like 2 weeks. ran into a gentleman that gave me the gift of gab and a little game, and I started pimping and pandering and pushing drugs.
So did that turn it around for you, that man?
No, I turned it around.
You turned it around?
So you
were down and out, and then this man came along and showed you how to pimp, pander, and get some game, and is that the high point?
That's still the low point, but I still had to go through the process and still face my obstacles and wake up on one day and go, this isn't it either.
Yeah.
You know? So I wrote about it. I had a beautiful...
What did you write? What did you write, Veronica? What are your feelings and emotions? What did you write?
He is a publisher.
I told the truth. I told it how it was and how it is and how
it
will
be. Dude, is one show not enough for you?
I have to be out of all day.
Well, someone get, floor manager, get
DeVine
out of the room.
Can we have some security, please? Excuse me, can we have security?
Okay. There's more Cracker Jacks.
No, security?
Here. Speak. Michael, speak.
I'm sorry, you know, Michael, I'm trying to have this interview. You come in here and upstage this lady.
Brian has invited me to be on the show.
Get out of here.
Talk to your department.
Get out of here. I'm serious, please.
Silk, please. Can you handle that for me, please?
Push that player.
Please.
Because he don't understand English, my nigga. He don't understand.
Get Michael out of the studio, please, and get that cockamamie flamingo out of here, too. All right,
LaShawn,
finish. I'm losing all respect.
Yo, son is trying to bounce, baby.
LaShawn, I want you to finish quick. We got like a minute.
Anyway, so basically, I just basically told my story in hopes that.
Honey, come sit next to me over here. Bring the mic. Come sit next to me. Away from that Michael, not upstaging.
And so come sit next to me, Silk. I'm gonna sit on Silk's lap because Silk's been mad at me lately because I ruined his whole video shoot because I told everybody 9 o'clock and he really wanted it at 4. So I'm sitting on a nigga.
I can't be having no man sitting on my dick.
Well, it was as uncomfortable as it was for you. It was equally uncomfortable for me.
When is your book going to come out?
All right, let's talk about her book.
The book will be released in the summer of June, in the month of June.
Right? Have you gotten a publisher yet?
I did self-publishing. I went through Rose.
All right, we need
books.
A publisher for this book.
I need all the
I think a lot of young ladies out there, and a lot of young black ladies, and a lot of young women who have been abused sexually or mentally can benefit from reading a book like this.
Coming Out of the Dark by LaShawn.
Renee Logan, also known to many as Pretty Boy.
True life.
And Pretty
story.
Boy also was in the Silk video, footage that we saw earlier.
Slikski. I'm also an up and coming barber, so I need to give heads up to Healthy Hair Academy.
You need to give head. What?
How come all barbers?
I'm gonna come to your shop.
Don't have any hair.
Anyway, I got one last thing. How much time we got? So, any of you guys paying attention?
A diamond and dime piece. Show diamond like that.
One minute.
Piece.
Do diamond. Diamond's Silk's other half.
Diamond, show them how we get down. Show them how fine you are.
Get a close up of her.
That's my queen. I got three other wives. Two other wives. They ain't here right now. I got two other wives.
Isn't she pretty? Oh, look at that. Pretty.
And I've noticed you've been doing something different.
You trying to pass this side. I'm single and looking, man. I'm single and looking.
Hey, hold up here.
Is that right?
I'm noticing that your hair's looking a lot really nice. Are you using different hair care products? Okay.
Yo, she takes about 3 hours to fix her hair.
Bring this in here. This is this week's Inquirer. Close up. Scott Peterson says, Lacey's baby wasn't mine. That's all the motive you need to kill her.
Jeez.
Right? Don't you think?
This is going out to all my Brooklyn niggas.
Bring that music up.
All y'all up in New York. Brooklyn, baby.
Sadie's, I'll be home.
Brooklyn Zoo. Brooklyn Zoo. Old dirt dog. Dirty, baby. Protect your neck. Don't, hey, you know what I'm saying?
That hat.
You know what I mean?
No,
you know how we do.
It,
yo, Buddha Monk. What's up? Race on.
And there's Michael's
12 o'clock.
Bring some music up.
You know what I'm saying? Murdoch, Shorty Shit Stain. Yeah, I like that. You like that, right? Roll it up. That's how we do that. Roll it up.
Everybody out there,
all right,
with
my God. Nigga
Mook. Anything's possible.
Roll it up. You know what I'm saying? Yo, Spear. I just had it clean, that's all. I be rolling in the dirt with y'all niggas.
Upside Down TV rocks!